Hi guys, it's Rihanna, and today's show is rated R because I'm taking over.
We're live in New York City. I've got a shoulder pad on. It's all going to be fine. Rihanna is here. Interesting. You didn't like my shoulder pads, but you like Rihanna. She'll be here all show. It's Rihanna Day, which is not to be confused with the actual Rihanna Day, which is in Barbados. I looked it up. There's a whole day that's for her. America's best dance crew champions, We Are Heroes, will also be here later and doing what they do best in an extraordinary performance. So that's exciting. I've seen them. They're performing over there. They're all wearing suspenders and stuff. It's happening. But without further ado, please welcome Rihanna. Hood situation.
Thank you. No nail polish is hot.
Thank you. It's got the glitter over it.
I see.
It's not ideal.
It's pretty.
So I watched your Diane Sawyer interview on 2020.
Oh, you did.
And I thought you were very brave talking so candidly and frankly.
Thank you.
About
Thank
your experience.
You so much.
Are you glad that you can now move on now that you've done that?
Yes, and that's one of the main reasons I did it. And also to, you know, give insight to young women who are going through or have been through the same thing that I have.
And how's the fan reaction been? Has anyone...
It's insane. And for a little statistic, there's the National Domestic Violence Hotline, and the calls went up by 59%.
Wow.
And the helpline geared towards teenagers went up 73% since the interview. So while people are busy giving negative feedback and making up stories, it's actually helping save lives. So
absolutely,
look at the positive that comes out of
the situation. We've actually got an amazing treat for one of your fans here today. Andrea is backstage. She was specially selected to receive a Rihanna makeover. There she is, looking lovely. Andrea, where are you from?
I'm from West New York, New Jersey.
Lovely. And what is it that you love about Rihanna?
I love how her style is really fierce. Like when looking through fashion magazines, she's always the person that stands up to me the most. And she even inspired one of my most recent looks by wearing gladiator heels to a party, and I thought the outfit was really great.
Oh, very nice. There you are.
Nice.
Looking lovely there.
Thank you.
So, helping Andrea look the business is celebrity hairstylist Tish Celestine. Hello, hey. Tish.
Hi, Alexa. Hi, Rihanna.
Hey, Tish.
What are you going to be doing with Andrea's hair?
Well, Rihanna had plenty of fabulous hairstyle, but we're going to do with Rihanna today is give her an ultra-chic faux hawk with Rihanna's signature highlights.
Very nice. Very nice. Are you going to be shaving the side of her head there?
Excuse me?
No, she's not. Okay, so makeup artist Mosi Singleton is there as well. Mosi, what will you be doing to her face?
Hi, Alexa. Hi, Rihanna.
Hello.
Basically, what we're going to do is Rihanna has bold color always, so we're going to do a bold eye with a nude lip.
So pretty there.
Thank
Real
you.
Nice.
You're so nice today.
Okay. So, you're playing nice. And celebrity stylist Robbie Amadeo is there.
Hey,
Robbie.
How are you guys doing?
Talk to me about clothes, please.
Cool. For Andrea's makeover, we're going to reference Rihanna's signature rocker chic style, mix up some leather boots, maybe some blazers, some hot metallic jewelry.
Sexy. Awesome. It's going to happen. Yeah. Okay, so this is going to be taking place throughout the course of our show, and later we'll reveal Andrea's Rihanna-inspired makeover, so stay tuned for that. Okay, so back to you. Like this. So everybody knows that you're from Barbados.
Yeah.
How often do you get to visit home?
Not as often as I would like to.
Mm-hmm.
The last time I was there earlier this year, just before the summer. It's hot all year there, so it felt like summer anyway, but it was in like April.
Nice.
Fun.
Is it true there's National Rihanna Day there?
There's
that's so good.
They celebrated my birthday as well as me winning my first Grammy.
Amazing.
On the day after my birthday, 2 years ago.
Amazing. So it's not a yearly occurrence though. it was just the one-off? Or do they, or every birthday, do they do a Rihanna Day where everyone gets Rihanna tattoos and rolls the barrel out?
I don't think it's an every year thing.
Okay.
No, it
should
happen that one year.
I've announced it now, so it has to be. So, speaking of tattoos, let me get a close-up on this hand scenario.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Real nice. Look at this. When did you get that one?
I got that in New Zealand. It's their traditional way of tattooing, a Maori tattoo. And it's a tribal tattoo, and it represents strength and love.
Have you got any plans for another one?
I never plan my tattoos. That's the thing. I just wake up one day and I'm like, I have to get a tattoo. I just feel like getting a tattoo. And the ideas come, and you know, it's always something I love though.
Yeah.
Because I've come to terms with the fact that it won't be going anywhere.
Exactly.
So I want to make sure that I love it.
So can you get one of me doing this, winking in a bikini? Because that's my dream, that someone would get that tattoo.
Only
I think
if
it should be
on
you.
Bikini.
Oh, of course.
We can
from behind, like that. Horrible. Absolutely horrible. So you've got a new album out. It's called Rated R.
Yes.
It's coming out soon. Neo wrote your first single, Russian Roulette. How does that work? Does he come to you with a song, or do you commission it from him?
Well, actually, Neo gave me one of my first songs, the first song that we did on the album. It's called Stupid in Love, which is a really, really beautiful record. But that was at the top of the record, and Russian Roulette came at the end. So in between there, we spent a lot of time just, you know, talking, getting to know the story and what I really wanted to say, because he wanted to make it accurate. And the sound was really dark, which kind of matched the bass of the album.
Yeah.
And we just loved it. Lyrically, it was so powerful and clever. I love that it was metaphorical. And we just kind of...
What's your favorite lyric from it?
Hmm.
Do you have one?
Well, there's the part where it says, you notice him being here. And obviously, if he's here, that means he's never lost this game.
Yeah.
Because Russian Roulette, you know, of course, someone dies at the end of the game. So that alone just makes me scared all over again, thinking about, wow, now I'm getting used to being in this seat and I know I have to go next, but I'm playing against the master of the game.
Yeah. When you're not busy recording, what do you do to unwind? Do you ever get time to relax?
Sometimes.
Or do you have any special hobbies or anything that you do?
I just love watching TV.
Yeah?
More than anything. I have a guilty pleasure. I like those reality TV shows.
What are you into at the moment?
Hmm.
The Hills, The City, all of those MTV ones. Sure.
Actually, not really The Hills.
No. Just say it. Stings. We've got a clip of your video, which is called Wait Your Turn. It was released online, so this is its television premiere. Here it is. Some of our most famous fashion pieces, but until then, here's a break. See you after which.